Ask for the truth on behalf of Carla Jean Quayle concerning relationship issues. She's been feeling a bit down since her father passed away. And she's wondering, there's a person she's thinking about, the one for her, or what's going on here. Ask in the name of truth, right conduct, peace, love and non-violence. Blessed be to the truth. Always. We'll just place the cards over here there, Carly. Sadly, your father hasn't got a name, which is, I suppose, a bit disrespectful to them when they've just passed, but given the fact we can't do a mediumship reading if we haven't got a name because we don't know who we want to talk to. So we'll just focus on the relationship side of it and just see what spirit has to say about that, given that was at least a question that we can try and answer. We'll just deal out this card here. The first one represents your recent past, your relationship in your recent past. Then your relationship right now is the next one. Then, of course, what will become of your relationship in the immediate future? That's an interesting question, isn't it? Which spirit will no doubt provide here. Let's just see, first of all, where your relationship was between now and this time last month. As we just flip the card over here, notice there you've got the Satyr, Satan. The word Satan comes from that, the word Satyr, because the Satyr is the half man, half goat mythical creature there that represents revelry and indulgence. And basically, I suppose, overindulgence. Maybe you've turned to drink or God forbid, drugs, I suppose, if there's a God to forbid it. Depends what you believe in, but either way, when he says reveling in indulgence, I sort of got a feeling as though maybe not so much the reveling and enjoying yourself, but certainly drowning your sorrows just recently. Helps but doesn't help at the same time, does it? Let's just see though what's going on now and whereabouts you are now in the situation. We'll just rotate this card here. And you've got an elemental energy there, the element of water. Just indicating really that right now your emotions are at a peak, in the sense of feelings are strong right now, which is understandable, isn't it? You're bereaved and you've just lost your father there, not long ago. So maybe with feelings at a peak, emotions at a peak, or your feelings are at a very strong point right now, maybe, yes, you could be forgiven for the overindulgence, but nevertheless, is that the answer? What is the answer? Does the answer exist for the immediate future in the relationship? Is the person you're thinking about, yes, your feelings are strong for him, of course. But maybe even if the revelry and indulgence is the revelry in the sense of meeting the person at a party or something like that. But I somehow get as though that sort of indulgence in the sense of overindulgence. I sort of got a feeling as though that's more to do with access than anything else. Let's just see what this energy is for your immediate future. The Griffin just indicating honour and good luck. It looks like your luck will change in some regard between now and this time next month, where, yes, you'll be respected for how you feel, you'll be respected for the way you are, and nevertheless, maybe it's just a matter of principle. Will the person that's on your mind be the one for you, though? This is an interesting question. It doesn't seem as though it's been answered, does it? I want to pull out another card just to see if it will vibrate with the Griffin. If the honour and good luck could indicate something positive, of course. But it's more to do with the energy of the Oracle. Just indicating that you've got to seek advice. You've got to seek guidance from elders. Seek wisdom and guidance from elders on this matter. Maybe people who are older, people who are wiser in your own family, seek advice from them. Maybe do your homework on the person that you've got your eye on. Is he who you think he is? Is he what you think he is? Or is he just what you think he is? Or is what you think he is what you're hoping that he is, so that you can have a recent relationship with the person you want as opposed to the person who is? And that is a very sort of dark way of looking at it. I want to pull another card here, I really do. I'm getting a bit too, what's it about these cards, aren't I? For you there. Yes, so you're destined to succeed with the Talisman, of course. If you use knowledge as power, of course, and if you seek knowledge first, do your homework first, then yes, you are destined to succeed with... does that necessarily mean, though, the person... Does that mean that necessarily the person who you've got your eye on? I don't know about that, but certainly you will find... And the feelings that you've got right now, you will sort of, I suppose, succeed in this around about August time, maybe July, sort of summertime is more to do with, yes, your luck will change in that regard, and it's time for doing your homework through June, but around about midsummer, July, the end of July, August time, you'll discover that maybe whatever situation you're in by then, you will be onto a winner, as you could say. But just for now there, I think really it's just a case of remembering those who've gone. Sad that we couldn't try and get a sign or a message because we don't know who we're contacting. But in memory of your dear father there, I'm sure, hopefully, he is watching over you in some way, shape or form. And no doubt it's affecting how you feel. And maybe that's what it is. Maybe you're looking for somebody who is like your father. Because a lot of girls look for people who are like the father, like a lot of boys look for women who are like the mother, because girls like being fathered and boys like being mothered, don't they? It's that sort of thing, isn't it, going on? And I think that's just really what it is like with you. You're doing your homework. Is he like me father enough so he can father me and look after me? And you'll find this out around about July-ish to sort of Augustish sort of time, if there's such a thing. So with that then, I suppose we can say blessed be, and to your dear father, may he rest in peace. We don't know his name, but nevertheless, may he rest in peace, and blessed be to all absent friends. And for you, in the land of the living, these cards have spoken the truth.